What's up everyone, how you doing? Blue Nerd here and welcome back my friends to our Minecraft Medieval Docks, where I teach you guys how to build in Minecraft. Now today we have a really simple little house here, and this is a perfect little survival house. So if you want to build this as your starting house in survival, this would be perfect. It's got a bunch of really easy resources to gather up. It's nice and simple to build. It's a really cool little starting build. Now I have a bunch of builds in this design that are going to be coming soon, so if we quickly just spin around to the side here guys, you can see we've got the little blacksmith. Over here we do have a little stable. I'm going to be doing the wall in tomorrow's build here, so you'll be able to start getting in the walls for around the edge of the city. The gate we done in the last episode. We've got a little market stall down here, which I will be adding a few more of these around here as well. This one we've previously done already as well. This is like a little woodcutter's starter house. And then we've got a couple of other little houses just around the sides here. And I do have probably about another 10 designs that I still got to add to this little area here. So we're going to be doing all of those over the course of the next few weeks, plus a bunch of other cool builds that I've got coming as well. Anyway guys, we're going to start off with this one in today's episode, and like I said, this is a pretty simple little build and is great if you're starting out in survival. You haven't got to be following along with the series if you don't want to build this one. But with that being said guys, let's go ahead and see what we need to build this one. Okay guys, here is the layout of the floor plan, and as you can see this one is really simple. We've got that one little red block there, that is just a one block wall. Then we've got the green, which is two blocks, the yellow is three, and the pink block is eight. Now guys, I'm just going to quickly run all the materials you're going to need across the screen now, so be sure to check that out. Pause the video if you need to so that you can write it down and gather it all up if you're planning in survival. But with that being said guys, let's go ahead and build this. Okay guys, let's go ahead and start with getting in the foundation. So from the left hand front corner here, we're going to start with this one here. So one on this corner, and then we're going to go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's a row of 10 in total on the left hand side of the build. Now from that one where we just left off, we're going to put 2 to the right. Then we're going to go down diagonally to the right, place 3, come down by 1, diagonally to the right, 1, 2, down by 1, 2, 3, 4. To the left, 1, diagonally down to the left, 1, 2, 3, to the left, 1, 2, diagonally up to the left, 1, 2. Now, this is just the basic foundation, and the shape of this build is a little bit tricky, but it should be easy enough to follow along now. So, this is the front of the build here. We're going to go to the right-hand front corner over here, and we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on top of this one. This should be 6 in total now. And we're going to do the same to this corner behind it, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're going to join it up like this. Now, go ahead and join the two corners at the very top all the way across and join it up to this side here, just like this. And do the same with this one as well. Now, back to the front of the build here, we're going to start by raising this corner here to 4 blocks high. So there's one there already, so 2, 3 and 4. And then we're going to fill these two here across like this. And then these two here as well to the same height. On this side here, we're only going to go 3. So we're going to go 1 and 2, which brings it up to 3. And the same for these two just here. Now, in the corner over here, we're going to bring this one all the way up to the roof. Then we're going to go ahead and bring this one underneath all the way across to here. And we're going to add one more layer underneath. So we're kind of just making a bunch of boxes at the moment. Now, onto the left-hand side here, we're just going to go ahead and put a wall across at the top there. And then we're going to go ahead and just fill all of this section in all the way to the top. Round the back here is pretty much the same as we did the other side. So this side here is going to be 3 blocks high. So we're going to raise this one by 2 blocks to bring it up to 3. And then this one is going to be raised by 3, making it 4 in total. And we're going to bring that all the way around here. This one here, bring that all the way to the roof. Then we're going to add 2 rows like this all the way across to this side. Finally, come around to this side here, and we're going to go ahead for the moment and just fill this in like so. Okay, to make it a little bit easier so we know where everything is going to be going, guys, we're going to go ahead, first of all, let's go ahead and just break a little doorway in this one here, okay? And then we're going to just break a single window there for the moment. Now, we're going to go ahead and get the roofs in place because this will just make it easier for planning everything else. So, first of all, let's get our stairs, and on the side of this little bit that sticks out, we're going to put three of them and then overhang by one, place an upside down stair here. Four stairs on top like this. One upside down one actually facing inwards like this time. And then we can place three planks behind it. Put four slabs across the top of that one. Now here we're going to place a row of four planks, bringing it out level with this one. And then we're going to put four slabs across the bottom edge of those planks. Now underneath the corner here, we're going to place a slab here and then out by one. Okay, so we're kind of going down and out by one, and we're gonna just keep doing that pattern all the way down until we are overlapping the edge of the build by one, just like this. Okay, then we're gonna bring this down by 1, 2, 3, place 1, 2, 3 on this one, 1, 2, 3 on this one, and then if we come underneath here, we should be able to go ahead and put in a solid block just there, and then we can probably go ahead and just put in one of those underneath here, and maybe we just fill this little edge in like so, just to make it look like the roof blends in a little bit nicer. Okay, now we're gonna just quickly pop up here, and I think we're gonna break this one here out for a window, which is from the very top row. We've got two blocks here, it's the third block across. Okay, we're gonna have a little window just there. Down the side here, guys, it's entirely up to you what you want to do with it. We're going to actually have a chimney down here. So for the moment, I'm going to leave the windows on this side. We're going to put a window here, and then this side here, I think we're going to put two little windows in this bit here. Okay, now that we've got our door and windows in place, let's go ahead and work on the main roof. So the main roof is pretty simple. On the right-hand side here, we're going to run a row of spruce stairs down here, overhang one at each side, and then place an upside down one behind it. Place another row of stairs across the top of those, and then one more upside down stair behind it. We're gonna repeat the same thing on this side, so we're gonna do our row of stairs, one at each side, upside down one, then we're gonna run stairs across the top of those, and then an upside down stair at each side again. Now, at this point, we're going to place a slab on top of these two stairs. Place one slab coming inwards, one upwards, one inwards on both sides like this, with one on top of those two, and that creates a nice little curved archway here. Now, we're simply going to come on the inside here, and on the top part, we're just going to bring the slabs all the way across. Make sure it's only on the top part, like this. And then once you get to this side, guys, we're going to go ahead and place one here, and one there. Just to make that roof a little bit more even. And then underneath here, we can place a four block just there. Another one here, two in here, two in here, one in that corner, and one in there. And then let's go around to the front of the build, and we're going to do exactly the same. So let's just run a row of blocks across the bottom, and then a row as we can in the top like that. Okay, that is looking really good. Now, at the back here, we're gonna kind of repeat this roof here on the back. So let's start with our stairs, and we're gonna start obviously with this side this time. And we're gonna take into account that this side is overhanging this edge. So we wanna bring the roof out one further. So we're gonna go upside down stair here, one more, and then one and two. Place two upside down stairs here, and then one, two, three, four across here. Upside down stair there, three solid planks behind, and then four solid planks next to it. Where the stair is in the middle there, we wanna run a row of slabs, and then run a row of slabs across the bottom half of this. Then from this corner here, we're gonna place one below it, one to the side, one below, to the side, below. And then once we get here, we come over by one, and then one, two, three down here, three in here, and then three across in here. Then we can get our stone block and place one just in there. Okay, now before we do anything else, guys, let's just quickly go ahead and break the block in the doorway and replace it with a full block of your choice. I'm going to go with the stone. Now, before we do anything else, we're going to go ahead and texture up some of the walls so that it looks a little bit more nicer, because at the moment it looks very plain and rough and I really hate the look of the texture. So we're going to start by getting some cobblestone, and we want to place cobblestone more or less just around the bottom lower half of the build. Okay, but don't make it in a straight pattern. You want to do something kind of like this. So let's place two of them there. We put one here. Let's go up by one, maybe up to this one here. Maybe change these three like that. One here, one up here, one here. And then maybe something kind of like that, okay? So just kind of jagged into the bottom. We don't want the texture in here to be too much cobblestone all the way up. We just want to keep it on the lower half here. So I think something along these lines is probably going to do pretty good. Yeah, something like that looks pretty good, I think. And I don't want to really do more than that. I think the one on the corner here, we're going to actually take that back to stone. Just there. Now, where the windows are, let's put either an upside down stone brick stair like this, or an upside down cobblestone stair. Okay, and we only want to put this where the windows are. This one up here, because it's right near the roof, I'm going to leave that as it is. But any of the other ones, we can replace them. So let's go ahead round here and put in a stair there. And then I think round this side, we're putting a cobblestone and then a stone brick. Just to vary it up so that it looks a little bit better. Now we're going to go ahead and get our stone bricks, and we're also going to get some ordinary andesite blocks as well. Just the standard andesite. Now, the standard andesite, we can just kind of pop the odd block in here and there, kind of anywhere really. There is no set place for where we want to put these. So just go around and just sort of sprinkle a few of them in, sort of all the way up the build, wherever you feel you want to put them in. This is just creates a little bit of a different tone to the ordinary stone and just makes it look a little bit more worn, I guess. Okay, once you're done with the stone, go ahead and start popping in a few of your stone bricks. And you don't need too many of the stone bricks. You just kind of want to just put the odd one here and there. Okay, make sure you don't put in too many, because too many will kind of just take away from the look. So we just want to kind of dot in a couple of them, sort of just dotted here and there. Nothing too crazy. Something like this. And these again can go in anywhere. Put them at the higher part of the build, the lower part. Just wherever you have too much stone in one place, break it up with a bit of stone brick. Okay, let's go ahead and put some windows in. So first of all, let's put a window in just there. And then on this side here, we're going to put a trapdoor like that. This is the spruce trapdoor. Let's do the same here, but we're going to put the trapdoor on the opposite side this time. So something like that. If we head round to the back, round here, we're going to do the same. Let's go ahead and put in some glass panes. And I think I'm going to leave them ones as they are for the moment. Round this side here, we're going to put in some glass panes like so. And I think we're going to leave that as well as it is. Now, grab your spruce door and your spruce planks. And on the inside of your house, go ahead and dig out all of your grass in here. You probably want to light it up in here because it probably is a bit dark, especially if you're planning in survival. So go ahead, break out all of your grass and replace it with some spruce planks for some flooring, or flooring of your choice. Once your flooring's all in place, go ahead and put yourself a door on the front. I'm going to use the spruce door. And there we go. That gets everything all in place now. Okay, let's go ahead and get in a few details. So first of all, let's make a little table outside here. So we're going to put in an upside down stair there and an upside down one next to it. Next to it here, we're going to put an andesite wall with two spruce fences on it. And on this side here, andesite wall, two spruce fences. And then on the top of the corners here, we want to place a spruce fence on this side. And then same on the side around here, just like so. Then we're going to get our spruce trapdoors and we're going to place one on the corner, one on this one, one on this one, one on this one. So there's kind of a one block gap between them all. And then we're going to go ahead around the opposite side and we're going to do exactly the same thing like this. That looks good. And then if you want to, you could do it on this little roof here where the stairs are. You won't be able to do it on this side here because we've got the slabs. But you can do it on the side where the stairs are and the same around the back here. So something along those lines. Make sure you put it on the front one. Okay, let's go ahead and get our chimney in place. So round on the left-hand side here, we've got an open bit of wall here. So what we're going to do is where the roof is here, find the center block of the roof and then just bring a row of your bricks all the way down. On the bottom here, we're going to go 1, 2, 1, 2, and then we're going to place one on here. Actually, let's just make them all one like this for now. We're going to place a stair on top of all of these ones facing in towards that center bit. And then on the sides here, just place a stair facing into that piece. And that creates a nice little bit for the chimney. Now, we're going to replace the stair here with a four block and then a stair on top. Then we're going to break this one in the roof here, put a four block in there, and then raise it up by one and two more. On top of that, we're going to put a campfire, and then we're going to put a stair facing out to the side of the build like this, just on top of it. And then we can get our trapdoors and we can start placing them around the campfire all the way around. And because we've only got one block on the top there, it allows the smoke particles to go through the actual stair itself. So it creates a nice look to it, which I think is pretty cool. Okay, let's get ourselves some lanterns and we're going to just add a little bit of light into the outside here. So first of all, let's go ahead and on the side of the build, let's just place a couple of lanterns like this. And also a couple of lanterns here like this. And maybe we'll put one just outside that window, just like that. And I think that is looking pretty good. Alright guys, now just for a final little bit of detail, let's go ahead and actually break on the right hand side here. Let's break these lanterns and let's go ahead and put some four blocks across here. On the lower half here, we're going to put some slabs and then on the corner here, let's go one down, one over, one down, one over. Okay, so four blocks out in total. Then we're just going to connect these ones over to this side here. Just like this. And of course, don't forget to add that extra slab underneath to make the roof all look level. Now, we're going to go ahead and on this corner and the back corner, we're going to put a fence. Then the andesite wall underneath. And we're going to join up to this side and then join this one to the corner like so. And that creates a nice little area there on the corner, which I think looks really cool. Now, other than that, guys, it literally is just decorating it up and just making it look a little bit homely and, like it's been used. So, for me, I would probably go ahead and put in a couple of barrels, maybe something like that. We could go ahead and put one on there, something like that. Let's go ahead and put a barrel on the corner standing upwards. Put a little saw or a stone cart just there, maybe. If we grab our lanterns, we could go ahead and just crouch and place one on there. I think that looks pretty good. And then one thing I like to do in areas like this, because they're kind of a little bit more rustic and run down areas, I like adding in things like some leaves. So let's go ahead and just make a little vine in the corner here. As you can see, it comes up here. We're going to wrap it up over onto the roof a little bit like that maybe. We'll twist this one. Maybe let's put one there maybe and one there and then we could twist it over onto here and bring it down on the roof a bit like that, just to add that little extra bit of detail, you know, a bit like that. You can go ahead and add a few more bushes around the build as well, so somewhere like here, even around where the chimney is here. You can even connect a little bit up at the back here as well if you wanted to, something along those lines, maybe something kind of like that. I think that looks good. And just kind of anywhere you want to, really, guys, just to get a little bit of detail and just kind of make it look a little bit run down, because areas like this, you know, they would have a lot of overgrown hedges and stuff like that about. And just kind of dot a few things around. So we put in some ferns. Put one of those in the back there. Maybe a large fern next to it. A few little large ferns. I think the large ferns are really good. They make it look a bit overgrown. Add in a little bit of grass around here. And then go ahead, get yourself a shovel. And you just want to add in a little bit of detail with the shovel for a path. So go ahead, get yourself in a nice little path. Make it a little bit of a curved path. You don't want a straight path. And a little bit more rougher. The rougher the path looks, the better it looks. So something kind of along these lines. And if you get any of the little edges showing of the blocks underneath, guys, just go ahead and make sure you replace them inside like that. Maybe something a little bit like this, and then get yourself a few of your spruce fences. You can always add in a few little spruce fences, sort of dotted about, just to make it look a little bit nicer. And then bone meal is always a great way of adding in a little bit of detail around your builds. So go ahead, near where you got some of your fences and stuff, go ahead and put a bit of bone meal in. Maybe a little bit of an overgrown area around the side of the house here. Now, because the house is a pot, it has the little overhang at the side there, it would get used. So you would want to go ahead and just make a little bit of a kind of clearer path. So it looks like it's been trod on and walked around down here. It looks like a little kind of a work area. And I think this would be good as we can call done, guys. I think that is just about it for this one. Now, I'm not going to do the interior, guys, but what I will do is I will go inside my build that I built inside my world and show you what I've done with the interior so that I can give you guys maybe a little bit of inspiration for you to add your own interiors to it. But it's a very small space and there's so many things you can do when you have small spaces. It does make interiors kind of easier to make them look nice. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we've done in our world. Alright guys, so we are back in our world. Let's take a quick look at the interior, and the interior for this one is very simple. So as we come in the front door here, we've got a little desk over in the corner here. So we've got a spruce stair with some spruce stairs to make a little table with a flower pot, a little trap door up there with a lantern on to make a little shelf, a fireplace in the corner here using a trick that I often do, which is some stairs facing towards the walls, a campfire in the corner, a couple of stairs facing upwards. And then we just use blocks and stairs to create a little curve in the chimney and leading out to where the chimney is on the outside. Over here we've got a little table with some chairs and a little flower pot. A lantern here just to make it a little bit lighter. A little kitchen out the back here, very simple. We've got some barrels up there for storage. A smoker, a brewing stand, a cauldron, some more storage over here. Nice and simple really. And then upstairs if we come up here, come up to the little room up here, we've got a loom over in the corner here, we've got our barrel, our beds over in the corner, and yeah, just neatened up the roof a little bit and just kind of finished it up. And guys, that is just about it. Now, as always, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you did and you want to see more tutorials along these lines and some smaller tutorials just like this one, so the one that we have over here, so we've got the blacksmith, we've got our little stable over here and a bunch of houses and stuff over here. Plus, I've got a bunch more that I'm working on. So if you want more tutorials like that, guys, be sure to let me know in the comments. But for now, guys, we're going to go and wrap it up just there. So as always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy it, don't forget to smash that like button. And if you're new to the channel, then please consider subscribing. Just don't forget to hit the notification bell so you get notified every time I post a new video. But for now, this is Blue Nerd signing out, and I will catch you guys in the next one.